What's up?
What's good?
What is up? What is good? Welcome back to another episode of The Blind Spot. And today I'll be doing another portrait review. Towards the end of the last season was really fun to do this because I was able to showcase your work and see a lot of great talents. And hopefully I can work with you guys soon after all this pandemic. And I hope you guys are still safe, by the way, all right? Before the last season ended, I asked some of you guys to send some of your best urban photos or urban themed photos, and it's really general, right? So I saw a lot of great shots and I picked 15 from those entries. This will be a two-part video, so stay tuned for the other one if you guys want to check it out. Don't worry, I won't stretch this any longer. I want to say thank you first to everyone, and if you guys want more, just subscribe to my YouTube channel, like this video, and comment down below if you guys want more. All right, let's start off. This is the very first entry. This is from Giancarlo Cielo or Sky Photo. So first and foremost, I love the colors here. You know, despite saying urban, most of the time they're putting grays, blues, greens, or whatsoever. This one has vibrant pastel colors, and he used the architecture of the building or the place or the spot properly because he lined it up in the middle of all those frames from the building. And the pose of the model is pretty much really cool. I love the dress or the color of the dress as well, and she looks great. And to be honest, he aligned it properly. I don't know, probably in post-processing or probably during the shoot he aligned it, so I love it, especially how sharp it is and how enough bokeh or enough depth was showcased. You know, that's one thing that I want to showcase as well with my works now. When I use wide lenses, I want to use the aperture and showcase depth, but I don't want to eliminate the location, because you know, you invested for the location, you walked, you went there, and you're just gonna blur it all out. So this is a great example of really nice execution of wide lenses with, you know, great aperture. So great job. Next one is by Alexis Mundala. This one, I'm very familiar with this spot. I think this is in Makati. I'm not sure, I think in Soto Street, but this one is a great example of urban shot that I am very familiar of. I love the outfit, I love the posing, the framing. He's a bit to the right of the shot, but what I like about this is that the utilization of the spot and of the accessories. You can see how the gray green is mixing in the background. There's like a green tint all over, and I love that the skin tone is very fresh. I love that the lips are pretty much red. Sometimes we kind of eliminate that part when we're editing, but you know, I love that you retained that one. The outfit was showcased properly. I know it's just half, but I've seen the three layered belt, the leather suit. I think this is leather. This is hot. Anyway, this is really hot for me. I don't like leather, but this one is executed well. And to be honest, given that this is a very common spot for some of the urban photographers that is based in Manila, Makati, or Quezon City, or anyone who's going to Makati, this is well executed. I know I'm familiar with this spot because I almost got hit by a glass from the building here. But to be honest, this is well done. I love the framing. I want to see more of this shot. Probably, if you want, just share it to me. I'll showcase it. And also, I want to see a whole body shot of this one because this is great. All right, make sure to check out Alexis Mundala's work. All right, so next one is by Anthony Guevara. Okay, this one, I love that, you know, especially with urban shots, most of the time when you're using the buildings or spots or alleys or stairs, most of the time you can utilize it or make it look good by aligning it with the lines or the linear directions. And this one, I think this is a set of stairs probably. So you used it and properly aligned it with your shot. I don't know if you did it on the spot or probably in post-processing, which is fine. And this is well done. I wish that you just gave it enough headroom or probably a different angle, but this one is better because you showcase the top. Okay, because of I love the color of the jacket. This is a jacket, right? Or a bomber jacket. And I love that the skin tone is very clear. I kind of noticed some vignette because the dark edges. I wish you could have just made it a wider shot, but this one is well done. Everything is sharp. The eyes are pretty much on point, and also, parang wala siyang, how do you say this? Walang chismis dun sa shot, because most of the time, when you're doing urban or urban photography or urban themed photo shoot for your portraits, may mga times na may basura or something, this is very clean. So, well done. And also, this is a good example of retaining the blues. Most of the time, I saw urban portraits where they eliminate the blues and make the cement, make the buildings look gray. So, this is well done though. I gotta say, great execution. Alright, next one is by DC Rose or Rolex, please correct me. This one is probably one of my favorites because this looks futuristic. It has that post-apocalyptic work or look because of the gas mask and, you know, probably the setting. What I like about this is that you utilize the colors of the light one or the light, I don't know what you use for this one, or the fluorescent lamps, but you made it blue. I know sometimes teal is not something that urban photos are pretty much, associated with, but this one looks great. One thing that I kind of, you know, if I was there, if you see that fluorescent lights on the top, probably you could have just aligned her in the middle of it if there is enough space on the right, but, you know, other than that, this looks great. Using silhouettes and shadows to your advantage is pretty much a challenge most of the time when you're doing low light photo shoots, but this one is sick. This one is really, this is a good example of it. The gas mask looks dope. I don't know if you just added those X in the gas mask, but it's great. It's great, man. I don't know about the wardrobe because it kind of looks fancy, but still it worked for me. Great job, bro. This is by DC Rolls or Rolls. Rose, please correct me. I love the bucket hat too. It added them some shadows to the face. I can still see a hint of the eye, but it's still under those shadows, so I don't mind it. This is something understandable why it's in the shadows. So you don't need to explain it to me. I can pretty much tell it. Great job. Next one is by Jello Himpisao. Sorry about that. So this one is a great example of using grays for your shots. I'm not sure if the color of his crop top is already gray, but you kind of framed her well within those, I think this is a gate or probably the playground, but this is well done because I think that you used the foreground of the grills to your advantage. The grays, I wish you could have just retained the greens because I'm pretty sure those are grass or like leaves right there. Probably just desaturated a bit, not too much, because I can't really see it anymore. It kind of blended to the building and kind of doesn't make sense for me. For me, okay, not saying I'm not against your shot, but it's just in reality, probably desaturating the buildings is nice, but sometimes the greens, it kind of takes away from the shot. But great shot nonetheless. I just love that you retain the skin tone properly. That's a plus. Next one is by Jaff. To be honest, this is one of the, you know, usual urban portraits or urban shots that I see when you're using to your advantage the crowd, the ones passing by, where you kind of shoot it in low shutter speed and low light, because low shutter speed, you can see some motion happening, because in high shutter speed you pretty much capture them in place sharp as well. So this one is really nice. I love that you use the frame of the grills of the building. I'm not sure, this is the vent, I think most of the time this is the vent. So great job on this one. If you could have placed another, or waited for some timing where there's two persons and you frame your model in the middle, I think that would work. So still great way of using urban portraits. This is like street photography where you're using somebody as a model and using the crowd for motion as foreground as well. So this is dope. I wish they could have just added more, but this is well executed as well for me. Keep it up. Probably add some colors because, you know, it's too black and white for me already, where the other colors is skin tone, but great job. Next one is by JMPKSSS. This one is very familiar with me because I live nearby. I live near this place, so I often pass by this one. And you already shot, or you already did a shoot where the bridge was already renovated, so you kind of use it to your advantage. The tones all over here is pretty cool. The yellows, the oranges, the gold tones of like the lamps or the street lamps is kind of blending to your set already. So that's great. And I love that you highlighted the shoe. I know that the shoe is kind of pretty much, you know, away or kind of different from the colorway of the whole shirt or the whole outfit, but it worked well for me because there's enough colors also in the bridge or the Chinatown Welcome Bridge. But one thing that I kind of noticed, you know, when you're doing shoots like this, I know pretty much on the go you kind of shoot, make sure that your model kind of fix their clothes, because sometimes it kind of piles up when you're fixing it and you kind of like do different poses, it kind of pulls up, and the clothes is pretty much like already balled up in the middle and it's kind of not presentable. So again, that's one tip that I can share to you. I hope that you can take note of that. Also, if you guys have time, clean up the place if you can, like sweep it all up with your feet. Anyway, this is a great shot, great use of the spot. Probably a lower angle and a wider shot could have done a better service of the whole outfit. And yeah, I hope this helps, man. This is just a suggestion to you. I'm pretty sure you can do something else with this one. So great overall look for me. Last one is by Just Mix. This is a really great shot, of a close-up shot. I know most of the time close-up shots doesn't showcase the spot or the urban tones, but this one has the colors of it. I love that you desaturated a bit of the background, but you could have retained a bit of it. I'm not sure if the color of the ones in the background, the window or the frame, is really black, but yeah, it kind of worked well here. The eyes are pretty clear, skin tone is on point. It's very, very close to the color of the jacket. I'm not sure if it has the real tone, but I wish you could have added more, just a bit. This is a great shot of Chelsea. This is Chelsea, right? So yeah, this is a great shot. Avoid taking out a lot of colors most of the time, because it kind of takes away the sense of the whole location, and I know it kind of alters the spot, but sometimes it takes away a lot. So there you have it, and I hope this helps, and I'm pretty sure that you guys can do better. These are all amazing entries, by the way. I'm not saying these are not good when I suggest something, but these are just tips that you guys can try next time or when it's already safe outside for you guys to shoot or for us to shoot. So thank you guys so much for joining. There will be another set which will be featuring the last part of the 15 picks that I did or I chose from the submission. So thank you guys, and if you guys enjoyed this, make sure to hit that subscribe button below, like this video, and comment down below what theme do you like for the next one. Peace. Flex your tones. Pressure, put heat on them. Put that 5-0-0 degrees on them. 500 degrees. Go dummy, go beast on them. I go beast.